theta to pi plus alpha, and I should extend this waveform here also. So the output voltage, so this is beta, would look like this, similarly here also. Phi plus beta. Okay, so output voltage is this. And similarly here also. Again, in this case also we could have this is again a full wave controlled rectifier. We can have the continuous conduction mode also in this, wherein the value of L is large enough to cause the current to be continuously conducting in the load. Okay, we can find out the value of beta. Okay, how? So we know that the current I omega t is equal to Vm by Z, so it is sine omega t minus phi plus, so plus, then again I have got this Vm by Z sine phi e to the power minus t by tau. So will this be the expression of current in this case? No, there will be a difference, because you could see here that now the starting point is omega t equals to alpha and not omega t equals to 0. So this expression of current will not be valid in this case. So you have to again find out the expression of current in this case, and that is not difficult. We can easily find it out. Okay, so how to do it? So it is quite simple. Let us see how we can do it. Okay, let me correct a small mistake that I have made. I have shown the voltage, this current waveform. No, this is not, this is the voltage here. Okay, so small mistake. Okay, so I was telling you that this is not the expression for current in this case. Okay, so how to find it out? So we know that the general expression for the current is, so in place of this I can write here k times this. Okay, this is the general expression for current. So we know that at I alpha the current is 0. So at omega t equals to alpha, what would be this expression? So this would be Vm by Z sine alpha minus phi plus k times e to the power minus. Now what about t? So omega t equals to alpha, so that gives t equals to alpha by omega. So I put it here, alpha by omega tau. Okay, so now I can find out the value of k here. K equals to it would be Vm by Z sine of phi minus alpha, and this times this much times e to the power minus alpha by omega omega tau. This is tau, not Z, this is tau. Rather it would be positive. So I'm bringing this on the left side, so it would be positive. Okay, now this is k. So if I put it here in this expression, I would get the value of current that would be flowing in the in this case. Okay, so one more thing, another thing is that this current could be continuous also. So in that case, when the current is continuous, let me draw it let me draw it. So the current is increasing, and okay. So again, it is varying from this point to this point. Okay, so it is varying between two points. This is say I minimum and somewhere I maximum. Okay, so in this case, so again the expression of what would be the expression of current. So in this case, now at I alpha, I do not have to put I equal to 0, but rather I would be putting this equal to I minimum and then finding out the value of k and putting it back into the expression for the current, and that would be the final expression for the current flowing in the circuit. Okay. So this is basically the AC transient analysis for a rectifier. And I hope you would have found this lecture informative. Okay, and so let me stop here. Thank you.